So, pretty wild game between the Senators and Flyers tonight. The Senators ended up taking this one 5-4 in overtime, but this was almost a disaster for them. Let's break it down. Austin Watson would open the scoring midway through the first to put the Senators up 1-0. Let's pick it up early in the second with the Flyers on the power play. Now, I'm going to be referring back to this a few times throughout the video, but I want you to look at the shots. At this point in the game, the Senators are outshooting the Flyers 17-2. To say they were outplaying them would be an understatement. The Flyers would tie the game thanks to a nice point shot from Tony DeAngelo. A few minutes later, Tim Stützle would score and put the Senators up 2-1. Less than a minute after that, Alex DeBrincat would take a run at Joel Farabee along the boards. Farabee didn't like the hit, so he takes exception and the two drop the gloves. They tie up immediately and DeBrincat just starts wailing on him. He gets quite a few good shots in, and I'm not sure what Farabee was doing, but he barely even threw any punches. I love it when skill players fight because it's so rare to see and it's usually pretty entertaining. I also love this moment when DeBrincat is in the box after the fight. Tkachuk, Stützle, Joseph, and a couple other guys come over and give him some stick taps and fist bumps. Look at how happy they all are for him as well. I love that. Late in the second, Shane Pinto would put the Senators up 3-1 with a power play goal. Early in the third, here's where it looked like the Sens were going to completely take this game over. Stützle springs Claude Giroux with a beautiful pass up the middle, and Giroux makes no mistake as he snipes one past Felix Sandstrom and gives the Senators a commanding 4-1 lead. I also want you to take note of the shots at this point in the game. The Senators are outshooting the Flyers 32-6. That's right, the Flyers only had 6 shots on goal through 2 full periods of play. I would actually pay to see what Tortorella said to his team during the second intermission. I have to believe that he absolutely ripped them a new one. So at this point, it looks like the game is over, right? Well, not so fast. A few minutes later, Cam York would bring the Flyers to within 2 with a beautiful shot to beat Cam Talbot. Just over 4 minutes later, the Flyers are on the power play and Rasmus Ristolainen rips a point shot which is tipped in by Noah Cates and he brings the Flyers to within 1. With 2:39 left to play in the third, the Flyers are pressing, looking for the equalizer, and Travis Sanheim sends a nice feed to Owen Tippett in the slot who scores and ties the game up at 4. The game would end up going to overtime, but just before the end of the third, I want you to again take a look at the shots. The Senators are outshooting the Flyers 44-11, and the game is tied at 4. I had to look at this number about 3 times to make sure that I read it correctly. This had to crush the Senators mentally as well. Like, can you imagine outplaying your opponent that bad and having the game go to overtime after you were up 4-1 in the third period? It's crazy. Luckily for the Senators, they would win the game in OT a minute and a half in as Sandstrom gave the puck away to Alex DeBrincat, who would score on the wide open net. A fitting end to a hectic game, I would say. This was a big win for the Senators as well, as this kept them alive in the playoff race. Let me know your thoughts below. Please like the video if you liked it and subscribe for more. Thank you so much for watching.